ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. For those of you that don't know me, I haven't always been Father Aaron. You see, last summer, PK called me up and asked me to marry him. It was touching and heartfelt, but in the end, I told him I just didn't feel the same way about him. But in all seriousness, I felt very honored in that moment. I told him that it would be my pleasure to stand here today and perform this beautiful ceremony. I first met PK and Carrie over 7 years ago, so I guess it's safe to say we are now officially past the 7-year itch. You see, my actual day job isn't a pastor. PK and I actually share the same occupation as pilots. Yes, I know, we're more than just a bunch of pretty faces. PK and I worked at the same airline here in Atlanta, which is actually the same airline Carrie used to be a flight attendant for. And shortly after I met him, he introduced me to Carrie, and I knew there was something special between them. Carrie and I have always been great at making each other laugh. Whether we're adding .com after every sentence, like, "We about to have a party up in here."
.com.
Or just being plain silly, you always know how to have a great time and make others feel special when they are around you. All three of us have made numerous memories together, times that I will always remember. You two are truly blessed to have found each other. I am so happy for both of you, and so proud of the couple that you have become, as well as the excellent parents you are together. So, without further ado, let us begin. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to share the marriage of PK and Carrie. It is right that you, their loved ones and friends, should share in this service. For what each of them brings into their marriage has roots in the love, friendship, and guidance for which you have given them. They believe that their greatest happiness lies in their sharing life together, and they pray now that your care may continue to surround them, and that their union may ever increase your gladness. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we know your presence is with us here on this special day of Carrie and PK's wedding, and we give thanks. We ask your blessing and love be with us during this ceremony, and to especially fill the hearts of Carrie and PK as they pledge their love to one another. May your wisdom and spirit pervade all the words spoken and all the love given here today, and that these vows offered will remain strong and true in the presence of love all the days of their lives. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
PK, God has ordained the man as the spiritual head, as the responsible provider, and as the initiator of love in this human relationship. By his enablement, your strength must be your wife's protection, your character, her pride, and you must live that she will find you the haven for which her heart truly longs. Carrie, it is God's purpose that you be a loving wife, that you respond to your husband's love and tenderness with a deep sense of understanding through a great faith in Christ who has brought you two together. It is our desire that you have the inner beauty of soul that never fades. May God remain the central figure in your relationship together, and may you never take each other's love for granted. Now the bride and groom have wrote vows to each other, and at this time they'd like to share them. And PK, if you may, you can go first.
Carrie, when I first met you almost 7 years ago, I stopped you from the bottom of the stairs. I had no idea where that sneak peek would take me in my life. People say that couples in love are supposed to get married, buy a house, and have kids, all in that order, and we show how it's really done. And you have met the most gorgeous woman, strong-willed, determined, forgiving, a dash of hard-headedness, extremely loving, self-sacrificing, and most importantly, one of the single greatest mothers to our son. So from this day forward, I choose to you to be my wife, my partner in life, best friend. I promise you my unconditional love, utmost respect, fullest devotion, and most tender care. I vow to respect your unique talents and abilities. To give you strength to reach your dreams, I vow to take care of you, to encourage you and inspire you, asking you to be no other than yourself. You have taught me many things about myself, and at times know me better than I do myself, which you know I tend not to like. I promise to comfort you and be there in times of darkness, distress, sickness, and even when those rough Alabama seasons begin to add up. In those times, I promise to take you into my arms and let you feel completely safe. So I'd like to finish up with this. An old myth states that man and woman were separated because the gods were frightened of how strong we were together. Men and women then were left to search their lives for the halves they lost. You are my half. They cannot keep us apart, so let the gods be afraid.
In that summer of 2011, I would have never imagined meeting into that crash pad in Austell, Georgia, would have changed my life for forever. There was something about you that just couldn't put my finger on. You were mysterious, kind, even-tempered, and you always seemed to appear when I was in the kitchen cooking or going out on a date. But what stood out to me the most was when I returned home from Trader's funeral. I had only known you for a month at the time. I was a sobbing mess, kind of like I am now, actually, who most roommates, and men for that matter, would have fiercely avoided. But not you. You stood in the kitchen with me until 3 a.m. that morning. You listened, you genuinely cared, and you were a shoulder to cry on when you didn't have to be. Looking back, I probably should have snagged you up right then and there, but I thank goodness you had enough courage to crash my creepy date that next week. As the story goes, the rest is history. PK, our adventure has been perfectly imperfect, and I wouldn't have it any other way. Not only did I hit jackpot when you walked into my life, but I was also blessed with the most incredible and patient father to our sweet app. The excitement on his face when I tell him you're coming home from a trip is one of life's simple pleasures. As we give ourselves to one another today, I want you to know how truly lucky I am to have you by my side. I vow to support you. In your dreams, to build a compassionate home for you and God filled with love, to share my whole heart with you always, and to always remember to show you how deeply I care and appreciate you no matter what challenges come our way. Whether we are in each other's presence or miles apart, I will love you no matter what. I'm so glad that you chose me.
Okay, PK, this woman whom you hold by the hand is to be your wife. She has given you one of the most sacred things under heaven, her life, her love, and her heart. You may bring her great joy or cause her deep sorrow. It is not what you bring her in a material way that will make true happiness. Remember that riches without love are nothing. The practice of those virtues as husband that you have shown will keep her heart one to you. Do you vow here, as you have promised Carrie, that you will be true and loyal, patient in sickness,